Hey everyone, I'm MoistPenguin and welcome to Storytime. So, getting right into it here. Couple weeks into Walmart, I've been moved over to third shift, and I went in at like I started at like 10. I didn't get out until like 7. But couple weeks into that, I was coming home. Or I was going to go home. I came out to the parking lot to go to my car. When, like, this guy comes off from, like, one of the other cars or, like, one of the other lots or something. Like, I don't know. I don't see. But, like, he just started yelling at me. Like, I had done something to this man. Like, I offended his being with the way that I walked or, I don't know, something. Like, he kept saying, you know, like, You're just part of the problem. You're just causing pain for everybody. And man, you're just a worthless piece. And like cursing for like eternity at me for reasons I still don't understand. You know, just man, you suck. Everything about you is dumb, and everybody is never gonna like you. And you hate, and like we hate you, and all that. And like, you know, and it was just that for like 10 minutes. And like, I don't understand why though. I never got an answer either, because like after like that 10 minute, probably 10 minutes, was like up or whatever, like he just stopped and walked away, leaving me to stand there in this Walmart parking lot confused. I didn't say anything to them. They yelled at me, and then they left. I don't know. It's a memorable moment from Walmart for me, being yelled at. That happened a lot. I yelled at a lot of Walmart. I don't want to be mean or anything, but like, people who come into Walmart at like 2 a.m. Like, the people that I met, at least, those guys were... Each one was a character in and of themselves. Like, it was just, like, everyone who came in there at, like, 1 a.m. was either, like, in their pajamas and looking like they did not want to be alive right now. Or they looked like they were just... insane or like on drugs. I mean like, I don't want to be too mean about it, but like, you know, this is like what they look like to me at least. And I don't know if I told this, I'm pretty sure I told the sock lady one. That one was weird. That lady was really weird. They came back later that night after they had decided that they didn't have any socks, and they came over to me and were asking about like some kind of cup that we supposedly had in stock, because they totally checked it online and it said that we had it in stock here, but like I had never seen them before, and also I had never put one on the shelf before. While I worked at Walmart, I started off in clothing, and then when I finished clothing, I moved on to the baby aisle, and then when I got finished with the baby aisle, I was supposed to move on to the general goods place, which the clothing aisle took a long time because it was usually just me, and we have like a huge department for boys, girls, men, and women. Even babies included in that. I hated that job. I'm glad I'm out of it. But anyways, moving on. The next one that I wanted to kind of tell about was Magic the Gathering, the card game. I really like that game. It's a lot of fun. I got into it probably it was either my sophomore, like the end of my it was either the end of junior year or the start of my senior year of high school. It was one of those two. But my friend Warren, we were in theater. And it was just kind of a downtime. We were up on the stage where there was like a table in the back. And then we said, he was like, hey man, you should play this game. It's called Magic. And I got decks and stuff. And it's so much fun. And like, I played one of his decks. I think it was a, I think it was an artifact deck. I think. I don't know. Not too sure about that. But it was a lot of fun. And I remember whenever as I was playing it and learning it and he was teaching me how to play, I remember thinking like, you know, this is a lot of fun. I like this. And so I went to, I want to say there was a shop in the town over that I went to, because I didn't know about the card shop that was in the town that I lived at the time. Yeah, I didn't know that there was one there at the time, so I went to a card shop that was across the way that I knew about, and I got some packs from there, which I then used to buy or to build a standard deck. Which, if you don't know what standard is, it's just like their general rotation for the sets they have. I'm not going to get into it because it's convoluted and dumb. But, yeah. I made a standard deck out of that, and then I started getting heavy into it. And I started buying a lot more cards, and I spent more money than I probably should have. Not going to lie. I spent a lot of money on Magic. It's not good. But, and then I eventually got into my favorite format of Magic, which I now have currently got. See, I think I got like 4 or 5 decks now for that format, and it's called EDH, which is stands for Elder Dragon Highlander. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. I love it. If you don't know how it's played, you basically get 99 cards, and then one card, which has to be a legendary card, is your commander, and you base the deck around them. You can't have any colors that's not in their color cost. It's the game's a lot of fun, but the first deck that I really built for it, I can't remember what it was, but I remember playing with people once I discovered the card shop or whatever, and like knew that we could go down there and hang out and play Magic and just be dumb nerds with each other all the time. I started playing with people who had these decks that just like had like super combos in them. Like they would just win game after game. Just, you know, they could produce an infinite amount of mana or creatures or just infinite amount of damage or just take turn after turn after turn. And it was just like, eventually I started getting really bored with Magic because that's all I was playing with. And you know, whenever you're playing and you can't do anything, it gets really boring. That's one thing I started really hating the color blue, because it's very control-y and likes to counter what you're playing while also playing things that they play. So like, I really started to hate blue. Like, anytime someone was playing blue, I was like, man, I'm just not gonna have fun this game. Or like, man, I'm just not gonna play because, Jesus Christ, it just sucks to play against it. So eventually I got tired of, like, just playing as combo after combo after combo deck. And I decided, you know what? Alright, we're gonna do something about this. And so I built a deck around this set that I bought called From the Vault Annihilation. And what it was basically a bunch of board wipes and just destroy everything, basically. There was one that's banned called Upheaval. I couldn't play it, and I was very sad because it was hilarious. You turn all permanents to their owner's hands. So this is just like the board goes to everyone's hands. Anyways, I built it, and it was the commander was the card that you get in it called Child of Alara, which whenever it dies, you blow up every non-land permanent, which is what I built it around. And so like I sat there when I had that and I got home and I started looking up cards that like destroyed everything or exiled everything on the board that I could find. I bought all of them that I could. And I put them into this EDH deck and I slowly built it up to be kind of Voltron-y, which Voltron is like when you build the deck around the commander itself and you build it to buff him up and like beat the shit out of somebody with it. But yeah, I built it like that. And it worked. It worked a lot. Like, I had a lot of stuff that let me, like, okay, they would go to play their infinite combo, and I would just, like, I'd exile the permanent that let them do it, or I would destroy whatever let them do it, and then I would exile their graveyard. But, eventually I decided to move on from it, because I wanted to do something different. Because I had all these, things called planeswalkers, which are like players, but they're not, and they have abilities that are really powerful sometimes. So I decided that I wanted to make a deck like that built around them, and I realized, man, I need 5 colors to play this deck. So I decided to use Child for it, and so I started replacing cards in there for a Planeswalker deck, which is called Super Friends. And it eventually the deck got pretty expensive after a little bit of adding things to it, and I still need a couple cards to put in there to make it, to really grease those cogwheels and make it just right. But I decided to make the commander for it Progenitus, which is a 10 mana card, and it costs 2 of every color. Really sucks. I don't usually get to cast him in a game unless, like, I'm really needing something on the board, which I don't always need it, because the planeswalkers can produce tokens or, like, get shut down other things that I need to shut down. So it's not often that I just cast him just to have him on the field, but sometimes if I just have extra mana and I'm like, eh, why not, I'll put him on the field. Because, like, I'll show the card, but, like, he has he's a 10/10 and he costs 10 to play, and he has protection from everything. And I believe if he would die or something like that, if you put into a graveyard, I think you shuffle him into your library. I think. I can't remember. But anyways, he's a really powerful commander when you can get him out. And the only way that I know of to get rid of him is to wipe the board, or to destroy all the creatures, or exile all the creatures, or return all the things to your hand. You know, that's the only way. You can't target him, and I can't target him either. So, he's a very powerful creature when you can get him on the board and keep him there for a while. But, yeah, and so, like, I've been spending money and time thinking about what to put in the deck, what to build him in, and, yeah, it's just been a lot of fun, and, yeah. Magic, it's been a lot of fun. It's been a big part of my life so far. You know, I spend a lot of time playing it when I can. Just thinking about what I can put in the deck to make it better, just to have more fun. I don't really try to build unfair decks, you know, decks that like to combo up a lot and just, like, sit there and be themselves. Because I like to play Magic, and I want to have fun playing Magic, and I don't want to just play 3 cards and win, because, you know, it's boring. You know, what's the point of playing the game if it's only going to last, like, 3 turns? It's not. There's no reason to do that. It's just boring. But, yeah. That's pretty much all I got for this episode, guys. If you liked it, please leave a like and a comment down below. And do not forget to subscribe for more. I'll see you guys in the next one.